rules without markings are what commuters and vehicles contend with in Walwale, capital of the West Mamprusi municipality. It is a market day and the place is warming up to get even more congested, and nearby are these hawkers. They tell me lives are often affected.
Our problem is the road, no. The road is not good because there is no traffic here. So the motors and the cars, they are just passing anyhow, you know. If they do, they come and mark here, maybe it will be better. If they do the marking is not here. We don't have marking here. So we need to mark and then traffic. In this morning, three accidents happened here. So please, we want the road to be good for us.
And here, you know, it's corner, so some people, sometimes they will come and pass here, you see. Sometimes they will come and, one day, my customer come and stand here, and car come and push him away. And so here, you know, we want help. They should give us double road. The double road, you know, when we get it, maybe it will help us much more. Because the way the cars and the motor riders, you know, they are not riding well. They are not riding well at all.
The women are not the only ones complaining. Drivers and motorists also feel the impact. I caught up with Haruna Ibrahim, an executive member of the Ghana Private Roads and Transport Union in Walwale.
My brother, this road we are just talking on, you can see that there's no road mark on it. And the road sign will tell you the boundaries of the road. And in the night, when your vehicle reflects on, you can see the end of the road as you move. But if there's no marking on it, how do you even determine the boundaries of the road? How do I know that this is my lane and this is somebody's lane? And I want to tell you, you travel from Walwale to Nalele, you will see that those things are not there. The road is not marked. There's no road signs. Only what they only know, what we can see, is unapproved speed ramps.
A common feature here in Walwale is how minors whose senses of judgment may not be mature enough are dominating the operation of tricycles. The Road Safety Authority in the region is aware of the problem, but says hope is on the way.
All efforts are being made to identify intersections in the municipality that needs traffic controls. I call them traffic, not just traffic lights. But there are areas where we need to deploy police, there are areas where they need to put runabouts, there are areas where they need to put traffic lights. All that will be done in due course. And we are working very hard to ensure that roads that are connected and are working, road furniture is provided, general road furniture is provided for the use of the general public.
I caught up with him during the authorities' Stay Alive campaign in the Northeast region. The initiative is a national campaign to reduce road carnage before, during, and after the Yuletide. Bawo Gamson wants an implementation of very strict laws on commercial vehicle usage to curb the menace.
I advocate always, personally, that if the laws could be changed, such that
any driver
who recklessly kill passengers should be sentenced to death. That is my advocacy. Because you cannot bring a vehicle to load passengers and say, my tire is not good, but I'm going to manage. We don't manage with vehicles. We don't manage with human lives.
Meanwhile, Municipal Chief Executive of the West Mamprusi Municipality, Isahaku Arumiyao Somolaki, has announced that a contract has been signed with an Indian construction firm to dualize the main road to ease traffic congestion.
In fact, the government is now making Walwale main road, that is the commercial road, a dual road. As we speak, it has been awarded to Indians, that is the construction of Savulugu Walwale Highway. And if you get to Walwale Township, the road is going to be dualized. And doing that, it means that by the expansion of the road, more traffic regulations have to be added. So there's a plan for us to have a traffic light along the police station area from Wungu, coming from the hospital to town. We are trying to have a traffic light there. And then another traffic at the junction, the Nalegu Junction. I think when we are able to do that, we'll be able to at least minimize the traffic issues in the municipality.